Okay, finished taking down that shed. It actually took 2 days. Put the front lawn and it was gone within the hour. Now today I've been clearing down the brush around the shed. I gotta get rid of all this here. Eventually gonna clear all that later on in the year. And I just laid out, get a general idea of the foundation of how big it's going to be. It's actually a 10 by 10. I know I said 8 by 10 before. Well, it's going to be 10 by 10. No use wasting that extra 2 feet. So what I bought, I was going to originally just use 9 handy blocks or deck blocks. But what I read online, they should go 4 feet apart, and it would have been like almost 5 feet apart, and that's if you're using a 2x8 joist, but I'm using 2x6s, so I decided to get another 3, so I got 12 deck blocks, and I got a few bags of stone, got 6 bags, 1 bag for 2 of them. So today I'm going to finish the brush. I got 2 more days left of my vacation and I'll be doing the foundation. Hopefully I'll get it finished. I'm pretty sure I will. And then go back to work and then do the shed some other time, the rest of the shed. Okay, I just roughly laid out the blocks. Got rid of some of that brush there. And you know, I originally started with 9 blocks, just 3 in the center, and it was just iffy on the edge of, you know, recommendations. And I know some of you guys are probably going to say this is overkill, a waste of money, but an extra $25 for another 3 blocks, it's Canadian money, why not? Stronger support, can't hurt, right? So it's gonna be a big shed. Can't wait. I cut the bands and the joists. The bands are actually 9 foot 10¾ inches, and the joists, 6 of them, are actually 9 foot 9 inches long. And I just use a circular saw to cut them and clamp them down. Hey everybody, this is day 3 of shed building. The first 2 days was taking down the shed. The third day was clearing the brush and the area for the foundation. This morning I went and grabbed the plywood, the tongue and groove plywood for the floor. And so I'm going to stain and paint that today at the same time while I'm leveling the foundation. I got 3 sheets, and for the plans that I got, there's 2x2 feet left over from 3 sheets, and I really didn't want to spend $40 and get another sheet for just 2x2 feet, so I got some spare just normal 3/4 inch plywood I'm going to use for that section there. I thought I had some stain, but I don't, so it's probably better anyways. I got some older outdoor paint. One's ugly blue, the other's just white. So I'll probably use the ugly blue on the bottom of the plywood and the white for the floor for the inside. It's just added precaution to keep the floor underneath from rotting out, so I'll maybe give it a little bit more longevity. So I'm gonna paint a coat, work on this. Paint a coat, work on this. That's what I'm doing today. And I'll try to take you through some of the steps when I level it, okay? Very windy here today.
at that beautiful blue. And it's after I'm done the floor, it's gonna be a few weeks before I could start with the walls. So this plywood is gonna be outside, and not even though I'm gonna put a tarp over the floor, you never know, it might get wet, so this will help protect it till then anyways.
There you go, baby blue floor bottom. One thing I forgot to mention is right here is the lowest point, and that's low compared to the top. So if you're using cement blocks or whatever, I heard you gotta start at the top, the high grade, and then work down. But with these deck blocks, I can't really add a block at the bottom to make it higher. So what I'm going to do is dig as shallow as hole as I can on the bottom for the stones, and that way at the top I'll have to dig deeper hole to level it out. Just dug around each block just to mark it. Okay, I decided to level the outer stones first instead of going stone by stone. If you look, level there. Level there. And level there. And okay, you can see that's the lowest point in the whole shed. That's why it's coming off the ground. It's gonna have the most stones. Now after I aligned the outer blocks, now I'm gonna align the inner ones, and for that I'm just gonna use a smaller piece of wood and level it. I just leveled this one. One more to go. There we go. My first level band. Good morning. It's around 9 o'clock. And I get an early start today. Usually I haven't got start till around 2-3 p.m. Only having like 4 or 5 hours of time to work, but today I'm gonna have like 10 hours at least. And I got this tarp yesterday, 15 by 20 foot, and one of those things, it was on sale. Something that was on sale when I actually needed it. $15, half price, not bad. So I'm going to use this tarp to cover it up as I build my shed. Now I'm going to start on this side. I think I'm gonna try, instead of just going from the end blocks and align them first in the center like I did with the last one, I'm just gonna go to this block, and I want to make sure it's square here. That's why, before I proceed to there. So I just measured and spaced the stones properly, and then I marked the outsides where I got to dig. Sure that the corner is square. Square on the small and square on the large. So even though as I go through this it might go out of whack, but at least I'm headed in the right direction. Now I got my first joist level and finished and square. Well, as I keep doing this, I'm starting to learn more and get quicker at it. I was using spray paint to mark the centers, just to get a rough idea when I have to replace the block, but I realized I had chalk, so chalk would be better, eh? So I mark the center lines. Just so when I place the block, I got a general idea where I can place it. It's easier. It's going slow, but you know, I got up early to do a whole full day's work, but it's supposed to rain all night. That just sucks. It's my last day of my holidays too, so let's see what I could do. Okay, just to give you an update. I finished these three. And then I had to dig dirt out so the board would go across. And if that's level with that, if that's level with that, that's level with that, etc. Then this one should be level with that. And it's perfectly level. Oh my God. I was so happy. And then now I went to square it. By supposed to measure diagonals, and each that from there to there and there to there or whatever, and it should give you the same measurements. And the first time I did it, I was out 2 centimeters, and I just screwed around with it a bit, and now they're both 420 centimeter diagonals exactly. So what we have here, I'm not done all the blocks yet, but what we have here is a perfectly level square. Well, it's been raining off and on, so every chance I get, I come out here to finish it. So before I had perfect alignment. Now I installed those 2 blocks, and now we got the perimeter all in check. It's all perfectly level. Measuring the diagonals, they're out by 0.5 centimeter doing that. So I'm saying that's acceptable, and when I install all these joists and stuff, might get some movement, so I'll have to realign it anyways after. So I'm very happy with it. And so now, before I head off to work tomorrow, I want to finish it off, make this a little bit more permanent. So I'm gonna nail these bands, these two bands and two joists together. Three and a half inch galvanized nails. Going down on an angle just so I can hammer it in while on these blocks, but I do not want to take it out these blocks. Okay. One more hole to dig. It's getting dark now. It's past sunset. It's just twilight. And I just finished up, I got everything nailed. It's all level. And it's still out by that half a centimeter per square. But I'm happy. The main joists are done. I'm just gonna fill each spot with another joist. So another three joists. And then I'm gonna add the floor. But I gotta go back to work tomorrow, so this might have to wait till next week. Good morning, everybody, and I have to go to work in about an hour and a half. I got three joists I want to put up before I go and move all this flooring onto the foundation and then cover it with the tarp, because I won't be able to finish this till my next day's off.
Got left to do is install these joist hangers. Just adds more support, and I'm just going to use 1.5-inch galvanized nails that I found in my garage.
Completed foundation. I didn't need to put those joist hangers obviously on the blocks. The blocks are supporting them. So now I could go to work.